On the first day of the exercise, the Municipal Assembly made its first stop at Matichu. Over 50 wooden structures were destroyed. Residents were angered. They explained that they had nowhere to go. Most of them declined to speak to City News. Others were seen making frantic efforts to salvage their items before their structures get destroyed.
It was a caretaker.
Was there any amount involved?
Yeah, I paid money.
How much?
1,000.
A month or?
A year. It was a month, but we calculated it was almost 1,000. So let's take it that it was that, because it was 9 getting to 1,000. Maybe I went to take COVID-19 vaccine. I'm there, but they just injected me in a phone call. My sister called, they are scattering the things. I have to leave there. I took moto. Even the moto, the rider, I didn't even pay him. I don't even know where he is. Because the way I was even screaming, my certificate, can't you see this? I was not even thinking of it. My certificate is what I want. Uh-huh. So I came and this is what I had.
Now we don't have any place to go again. So we pray to the government. You should help us. Now the youth, I don't know how to say it, but the youth, we are very looking for some place, then we are not getting any place to stay. Now, if we want to rent a house, a room, more than 300 cedis a month. And some of us, our work that we are doing, they're paying us 500 cedis. And you remove 300 cedis a month to rent. How much will reach up?
The Municipal Chief Executive, Mordecai Akwasi, says the Assembly will not relent on its effort in demolishing more structures to bring sanity to the area.
Today's exercise is basically to remove a nuisance that has been created by the owners of vacant plots in this area. They have allowed, they've created what are called kiosk estates in the compound. In fact, this compound has almost up to 50 of them here, with loads of people living in it. You can understand how that is a nuisance, because there's no water, no electricity, there are no proper toilet systems and all of that. So the people who live here are a nuisance to the neighborhood. And therefore, the neighborhood prevailed on us. And we engaged them about 4 months ago and told them that they would have to move from here.
At the Sango stream located along the Cocoa Street in the Teshi Nungwa estate in Accra, works on dredging had begun. This comes after a City News report highlighted the struggle residents go through when it rains in the area.
Because first, when it rains, this serves as a buffer zone for the rain to subside. Then it comes into the gutter. Because of this structure, the whole place gets flooded each month that it rains. So we are pleading with the Assembly to come and, take the debris from the other side so that we can get a free flow of the water.
But the Assembly says, as part of the exercise it is embarking on this week, the plight of the residents will be addressed. The MC noted that an exercise to demolish structures on waterways will begin from Friday, July 8, to end flooding situation in the area.
We are clearing that waterway. We will break the structures. There are a few structures, including a church, which will go down. And then we have to excavate the filling that they did in order to build on the waterway. We need to excavate all of that and move it away from there. So it's a major project. It's not one that can be done in a day, but we should have started today. But somehow 48 engineers were not there in the morning. So we will start tomorrow and continue for 4 or 5 days until that thing is solved, until we demolish the structures and then excavate the filling that the people have done there.
He added that measures such as regular patrolling and planting of coconut trees will be done around the waterways to prevent residents from building on them.
We hope to find what is close to a permanent solution to the flooding that has been happening of late. Yes.
But how are you going to solve the issue where people still come back after you've demolished the buildings?
Okay. We put in place a more stringent monitoring program. We actually have people who are on motorbikes and ride around the streams and so on in order to check what is happening. It is also our intention to plant coconut trees to line the river so that people know that when anybody is building anywhere near a coconut tree, you must know that the person is in the floodplain.